let it be writ that on this day, by the light of the crystal, Eorzea ushered in a new era. The seventh astral era is come. And thus is ours a realm reborn.
Alfino, it is good to see you. Tell me, what have you learned?
Pray summon the others. Everyone must hear my report.
So this was all but a taste of what's to come.
Indeed. The main host advances upon Ishgard as we speak.
Whose vaunted defenses have been nullified?
Shorn of its wards, the city will bear the full force of Nidhogg's fury.
All those people...
Alfino is right. The Dravanians cannot be allowed to prevail. If Ishgard falls, all of Eorzea will suffer the consequences.
Then you agree that we have no choice but to intervene. For the good of the realm, the Scions of the Seventh Dawn and the Crystal Braves must join the defense of Ishgard.
Let there be no ambiguity about what has been proposed. We would be directly intervening in the war. But if all here believe the cause to be just, then to war we shall go. The path we now embark upon is perilous, but I pray you will walk with us to the end. For those we have lost, for those we can yet save,
then it is settled. I shall inform the Council of our intentions and request that they contribute their own forces to the defense of Ishgard.
Thank you. We are well aware of Ishgard's dilemma, and we agree with your assessment.
Then I trust there are no objections to the Crystal Brave's intervention.
Undar has not.
Gridania does not object.
The Crystal Braves are yours to command, Alfino. Do what you will. We shall pray for your success.
It was my hope that you would offer more substantial aid than prayer. I know it is within your means.
Do not presume that you have knowledge of our every concern. The Garlians and the Beast Tribes are but two of many. We are not in a position to contribute greatly to the defense of Ishgard, not when our own homes are still under siege.
We dare not leave our interests in Cartano undefended as well. Telegiad Allegi and his ilk would seize control of the territories in our absence.
The enemy is at their gates, and you would cower behind yours?
No one is cowering, boy. We will offer what support we can.
Aye, support. A handful of men and no more.
Would that we could commit more than a token force to this cause. Yet there are others to whom you might turn. The free companies ever want for work.
Ah, yes. The free companies. They're not like to turn you down.
I beg your pardon? You would entrust the survival of Ishgard to sellswords? Crises like these are the very reason why this alliance was formed. It is our duty to aid our fellow man.
My duty is to my country and my people. If you expect us to place the welfare of a foreign power above our own, you're going to be sorely disappointed. Lest you doubt, Limsa comes first, then the Alliance, and finally, circumstances permitting, Ishgard and the rest. If you cannot understand so simple a concept, then you have no place at this table.
Forgive me, Admiral. I was careless in my choice of words.
I suggest you assemble a party of elite adventurers, assuming you haven't already. Your fellows served us well during Operation Archon. I dare say they will do so again. If I may, Your Grace, I wish to propose a redistribution of forces. If we entrust the security of Uldar to the Brass Blades for a time, we can dispatch a larger force to Ishgard. Your Grace?
Yes. Yes, of course. Do what you will.
Is Her Grace not feeling well?
To the best of my knowledge, Her Grace is in perfect health.
I see. Carry on.
Thank you.